Hi, I'm Elizabeth Ayala.
And I'm Marissa Cruz.
And you're watching Royalty was crowned Friday night, and four students were named King, Queen, Prince, and Princess. The week was filled with games between the nominees, dress-up days, the rally, and the long-awaited crowning. We had field reporter Isaac Lucero catch up with the royal court after their win.
I'm Isaac Lucero here with Lexi Escandone interviewing her about winning Princess. So, Lexi, how do you feel?
I feel really honored to be Princess. Like, it's very exciting.
And what was your reaction?
I was really surprised because there was competition out there.
And who's your date to the homecoming dance?
It will be Ronnie Nicole.
Okay, well, congratulations, Lexi.
Thank you.
Now I'm here with Jacob Gonzalez, homecoming prince. So, Jacob, how do you feel?
I feel honestly pretty shocked and honored at the same time. I just like to thank all the people that voted for me. And yeah, that's it.
What was your reaction when you were crowned?
I was really shocked. I was actually preparing myself to lose. So like I had my head down, like about to congratulate the guy next to me. But when he said my name, I was like super shocked and psyched. And even though we didn't win, I feel like we had a really good game though.
Hey, well thank you, Jacob, and congratulations. Now I'm here with homecoming queen Anna Garcia and homecoming king Jesus Pimentel. So Anna, how do you feel right now?
I feel excited.
Jesus, were you expecting this honor?
At first, not really, but then since I put a lot of effort into it, like the entire week, I've been dressing out like a lot. I really had a lot of fun. I guess I did kind of expect a little bit, but not really.
What was your reaction when you were crowned?
My reaction was crying. I never knew I was going to win the crown, but I'm so excited, and thank you for all my friends to help me.
And Jesus, what are your plans now that you're king?
I am going to rule the world.
Jesus for dictator. Thank you. You like perfection, some kind of holiday. You got me thinking that we can run away. You wanna take it there, you tell me when and where. Oh, oh, oh. But then I asked for your number, said you don't have a phone. It's getting late now, I gotta let you know that everybody wants to take you home.
Thanks, Isaac, and congratulations to the winners.
First quarter wraps up. Some students are stressing and others manage to get everything done. We had field reporters Stephanie Sehal and Candace Mendoza catch up with some students about their first quarter experience.
Hi, I'm Stephanie Sehal in the news at CHS here with Michael Taylor. So Michael, how do you feel you juggled school and a sport or club?
Well, it wasn't easy. I had to manage my time and blow off my friends a lot, but I think it was worth it. I feel like I passed all my classes, even my college classes.
What clubs are you in?
I'm in drama and cooking.
Okay, thank you. And now I'm here with Melody Alvarez, Alder Pimentel, and Miguel Martin. So, Melody, what was the most difficult thing for you this quarter?
I think it's getting class on time.
Okay. And how do you feel you can manage school and homework?
Not procrastinating and not lagging on my homework and stuff.
Okay. And are you in any sports or clubs?
Well, right now I'm in CSF, and that's pretty much it.
Okay, thank you.
Hi, I'm Candace Mendoza here with Ruchi Rawal. And Ruchi, what activities are you involved in school?
I'm involved in a lot of clubs, which include leadership first and foremost, and then CSF, Link Crew, yearbook, and recently drama.
And how much free time do you have with all of that?
Free time is a joke. Free time is basically non-existent.
And how do you manage all of that?
Pretty much time management is a big factor of being able to balance everything. And when stress comes into the picture, everything becomes really difficult. Time management-wise, I would suggest do everything that's related to your clubs first, because I know that homework is a bigger priority for some people. And I know that I personally, when I go home and I finish homework first, I'm much more lethargic when I'm doing my club duties. So I would say leave homework for the end.
And do you think teachers can help you with like the stress, all the stress you have?
Teachers can definitely play a big part. I want to give a huge shout out and a huge thank you to all of my teachers who were so tolerant of last week, because it was homecoming and everybody was under a lot of stress last week. So I just want to give a shout out to all of my teachers and all of the faculty at CHS for being really tolerant with their students.
Well, thank you, Ruchi. And now I'm here with Fabian Eskindim. So Fabian, what activities are you involved in?
I'm in CSF, FCA, Link Crew. I also take AP English, AP Calculus, and I'm on the football team.
And is that a lot of stress for high school?
Yes, it's very stressful. But, you know, you have to do it, or I want to do it.
How do you manage all your time?
I just take one thing at a time and progressively get it done.
And do you think teachers could help you with the less stress?
Yeah, they give us less homework.
Okay, thank you, Fabian, and back to you at the studio.
Thanks, Candace and Stephanie.
One student has made the move to start and found her own club. Junior Leslie Alvarado is committing to better the community with helping hands through different activities such as community service. We had field reporter Christy Burke speak with Leslie for more info about her new club.
Hi, I'm Christy Burke with In the News at CHS, here talking to Leslie Alvarado about the club she's starting. So, Leslie, tell us about this club.
Well, the club I'm starting is called Helping Hands, and the basis of my club will be to create a positive environment in our communities.
What are some activities you'll be doing?
Some of the activities we will be committing to do this year is helping maybe the Herb's Kitchen, doing the Dowson Cranes project for the local children's hospital, and many more.
So when do you guys meet?
We will be meeting this Thursday, but every meeting will be held every other Friday.
Okay, do you have any more information you'd like to share with us?
Well, I really hope this is a common club in our high school. I hope a lot of you join. We need helping hands, so that's about it.
Thanks, Leslie, and back to you guys at the studio.
Thanks, Christy.
And now we'll go over to Zach Yeager
with this week's Horned Toad Highlights.
Hi, I'm Zach Yeager with this week's Horned Toad Highlights. For the first time in 23 years, varsity football came short against their rivals, the Avenel Buccaneers. A score of 22-28 ended the game. Touchdowns came from players Justin Douglas and Xavier Caetano. The Toads led the entire game up until the 3-minute mark, when the Buccaneers scored the game-winning touchdown. It was a tough loss for the Horned Toads.
We beat ourselves. We beat ourselves. This does not end anything either. They will get beat. I'm telling you right now, they will get beat. You have to control your destiny, nothing else. You can't worry about anything else except for your destiny and where it goes from here. Now, it's up to you. You can turn everything and just say, hey, we're done now. And we'll just phone everything else in. Or we can finish this out the way you're capable of finishing it out. Clean up the mistakes. All night long, we could not get any defensive penetration, but yet in practice, you guys are flying up the field. Why? Partially because our scout team isn't doing a good job. We have got to fix ourselves before we can worry about anyone else. Clean up the mistakes, guys. You are better than this. The best team did not win tonight.
We had field reporter Cassandra Garcia catch up with player Kyle Hedgecock for a recap of the game.
Hi, I'm Cassandra Garcia here with In the News at CHS, interviewing Kyle Hedgecock. So Kyle, if there's anything you can change about today's game, what would it be?
I'd say to change our tempo. We were real slow getting to the ball, and we didn't have it tonight. We just didn't feel it tonight.
Do you think it was a series of plays that caused it, or do you think it was like one particular play?
It was the whole game. It wasn't certain plays. It was just we got down too early in the game, put ourselves down, killing ourselves with fouls, and just not playing us, not doing what we do.
Thanks, Kyle. You guys played a great game, but it came out with a tough loss. Now back to you guys at the studio.
Thanks, Cassandra. This Friday, the Toads will travel to Mendota to face the Aztecs at their home stadium. Girls tennis creates history and continues their undefeated streak with 13 wins and 0 losses. Their win against Carruthers at home made the team ecstatic, with it also being their senior night. Destiny Torres caught up with some of the players and their feelings about this season.
Hi, I'm Destiny Torres with In the News at CHS, speaking with Carissa Miner and Emma Slinkard. So tonight was senior night, and I know there's a lot of emotions surrounding that, so can you tell us how that felt?
It was really hard saying goodbye. Like, I know that we have a lot of new stuff going on, but it's just hard saying goodbye to this part of our lives.
Yeah. And, what was your most memorable memory? Ashes ago.
We won 8-1, and so we all did really good, and we won overall, so we're still undefeated.
And what do you expect for playoffs now that you have a 13-0 record?
I expect to be seeded high, obviously. Hopefully we make it as far as we did last year, and hopefully we can take finals. Okay. But we're in a new division.
Okay, we'll miss you, ladies, and back to you at the studio.
The ladies will have their final game against Avenel today before they continue on to playoffs. Good luck, ladies. Friday, girls volleyball traveled to Mount Whitney High School in Visalia to face the Pioneers. They unfortunately lost with a score of 0-2. Today, the Avenel Lady Bucks come to Coalinga to face the Lady Toads. Good luck, ladies. This Friday, cross country travels to Woodward Park in Fresno to compete for the Rough Rider Invitational. They have a running rank of second place in Valley, with Avenel just barely ahead. Good luck, Toads. And that was this week's Horned Toad Highlights. Back to you guys at the studio.
Thanks, Zach, and thanks for watching.
And remember, if it's important, it's in the news at CHS.